I'm in conversation with Richard Allan, Vice President Policy Solutions at Facebook. He's based out of London and he straddles the very tough job of defining what policies are going to define politics and tech at the very popular Facebook. Hi, Richard. Thank you so much for joining us. You, funnily enough, have politics and technology merging. You're the person who everybody calls, you know, any government that they, when they have a query about perhaps what policy measures to define social networking, social media policies with, they probably call you and come to you. What are the funniest kind of, you know, requests you've received from governments around the world? And if you can tell us a little bit about that.
So it's certainly true that I've been at Facebook now for 9 years and for the first year, it was only me, so any government anywhere around the world would call up. Now we've got to a position, thankfully, where we have a team, actually, of lots of people around the world, including a number of people here based in Delhi, to deal with government queries. I mean, most of them are actually quite serious requests. So again, when I started, it would be everything from a missing child, and somebody needs to know how to get hold of us in order to do that, and we have a law enforcement team I can put them in touch with. Occasionally, it's about the politician's own personal profile and how they appear on the service, some content they don't like. But I say most of those queries are generally really quite serious issues that they want to raise.
All right. And, you know, politics and technology are both fairly, you know, now merging towards a time given the fact that elections are happening and, you know, with manipulations happening across the world. What is perhaps the one advice you'd give to people who deal with both sectors of policy and technology? And where do you see this going forward in the future?
I mean, I think the most important thing is to understand that if we want to find solutions that work for citizens, they will generally come from companies, governments, and experts working together. So governments can set the rules, but the enforcement of the rules often has to be done by the technology companies because we have the tools to do that. Yeah. So where we can become aligned, we can be very successful. And in some areas, for example, dealing with a horrible issue of child abuse material where people circulate photos and videos, awful photos and videos of abuse. You know, pretty much every government in the world has made that illegal, rightly so. Yeah. And technology companies like ours can come up with really clever solutions where we can scan for those kind of images and remove them before they even get seen by anyone. So that's a great example of the kind of partnership we need.
Right. So, but is it politics, the nature of politics that's evolving, or is it tech that's evolving? Yeah. And, you know, where do both merge?
I think one of the challenges we have is that politics moves quite slowly.
Yes.
It's deliberative.
Yes.
Politicians take 2 or 3 years to pass a new law, and that's quite right, because there needs to be a national debate. They need to be careful.
Public consultation.
Technology moves really, really fast. And I think one of the things I've seen, which is a challenge, is that sometimes by the time a law or a regulation is passed, technology's already moved on and is doing something else.
Okay.
So to the extent that we can make sure policymakers understand not just what the technology's like today, but what it's going to be like tomorrow, I think we'll end up with better regulation.
Thank you so much. Thanks very much for joining us.
Thank you.